Now we want to talk about a few more methods. We're going to continue to go through some methods, and then we'll end with a couple of our favorites. So one of the other methods that you can use, we've talked about this throughout the quarter, is to deploy a null model. Now this actually takes some practice. This is a little bit more difficult to do, to deploy alternative models, but believe it or not, you can do this with not a lot of statistical knowledge. If you're willing to do a little bit of programming, even if it's in something like Excel, you can be effective at this particular method. So earlier in the quarter, we had the opportunity as a class to call bullshit on Carl in his textbook, where in his textbook, he made a claim, he used a set of data to support the claim that athletic performance, physiological performance in humans declines with age. And here you see the decline for these record holders at these different ages, for the 100 meter, 1500 meter, and the 10,000 meter. But as we discussed earlier in the quarter, if you take a null model where every individual in every one of those age groups has the exact, you know, they're pulling from the exact probability distribution of performance, the only difference is that you change the group size for each age group, which we do know is the case, you get a similar decline. So if you go to the original data with this null model, very simple null model, where everyone has the same sort of performance probability distribution, you just change the size at the different ages, you get a similar decline. So here our null model reproduces the same feature of the original data. So it wasn't strong enough to support it. So here's the thing. You can't cite these data as evidence for your theory. So if you can do this effectively, this takes practice, but it's a very common way to refute many of the things that you may see at least veiled in data and in figures, something that Carl and I use quite often. So notice here that the alternative explanation does not even have to be correct, but in this case, I claim it is, to rob the original argument of its sort of argumental and rhetorical force. Yeah, so here's another example. So here's another method that we use is pinpoint where a false claim arose. So this is this idea that we want to track back to the source we've been talking about throughout the quarter. Dig back to the source. This is sort of one of the, if there's a couple things you learn out of the whole quarter, this is the thing that you want to claim. So earlier in the quarter, we talked a little bit about this MSNBC tweet that talked about how international student applications in American schools were down 40%. Now, all we did was, first of all, it sounded really strange, even though the immigration bill was something that, you know, that might, according, you know, based on Carl and I's opinion, maybe not the best thing, it doesn't mean that after that short of a period, you'd see a downturn of 40% at nearly all the schools. So we looked at the article that the tweet was based on, and it wasn't that they were down 40%, it was down at 40% of the schools. And even worse, when you go to the article that the news article was written on, it was down at 39% of schools and up at 35%. So clearly, the tweet was misleading. Carl, did you want to take this one?
Sure, I'll take over. So, you know, we saw the same thing for my friend who tweeted this about the difference in uses of words in letters of recommendation. So we did the same thing there. I went, it's the trend seemed too bad to be true. Went back to the original source and saw that the original source said sort of the opposite of what he tweeted, and then tracked down how he made the mistake. And that makes a convincing argument. Instead of just saying, oh yeah, my friend is wrong about this. Yeah, that's it. I said, my friend is wrong about this, and the mistake he made was he went back to the original source and he confused the hypothesis for the results, and that this graph is a picture of the hypothesis, not a picture of the results. That makes a more convincing argument that's going to be more useful in refuting things. We just did the same thing with the National Review, by the way, that we talked about earlier today. So having that explanation is a powerful part of the story.